What's good, everybody? It's your boy, O'Shea Duke Jackson, back at it again with another episode of The Celebrity Junk. So guys, some people have been emailing me about Dwayne Wade. And of course, Dwayne Wade is a very controversial man, obviously, because of what happened with the son, Zion Wade, who became Zaya Wade, the transgender daughter. Many people don't like that. And many people blame the fact that Gabrielle Union is the reason for that transition. But outside of that, Dwayne Wade, who's only 40 years old, Gabrielle Union, who was 50 years old, people believe that Gabrielle Union runs the relationship, that Dwayne Wade is not a man. And so he behaves as the woman in the relationship. He's even talked about how there is equal power in the relationship. And, you know, obviously a lot of women love that, that, you know, there is no leader. A lot of young women like that. We're going to just be honest and put that to bed here. No woman really respects, I think, a man like that. And these are the kind of guys that get cheated on. You know, these are the kind of guys that sleep on the couch. I'm going to tell you something here. I'm from the old school. It's my house. I live here. I'm running everything. Okay? That's how I do it. I'm from the old school. New man, old school. New time, old school. Women have their roles and I got mine. And if you don't like it, you need to go. Plain and simple. Long as I gotta get up and do everything I do every day, talking about equality, you stay your ass over there. All right? If you're gonna be with me, yeah. I don't have no problem with deferring to you. And, you know, women do have wisdom and God gave them that. They can see things, you know, and women help out a whole lot. But it ain't going to be no 50-50 equality over here, especially when women want guys to pay all the goddamn bills. But you want to be in a equality. No, that don't mean you got to be abusing somebody, whatever. No, but I'm going to leave. Goddamn it. I don't want to hear that. And that's just how it's going to be. But anyways, let me get back to brother Dwayne Wade. Dwayne Wade can't do that. Dwayne Wade is not that kind of man. All right. And so what happened is brother Dwayne Wade has got his wife's name tattooed on him as a birthday gift in honor of his wife. Now, some guys look at that as being very weak. Okay. Now, I'm not going to really deal with that because I think I know why this was, right? Some men in relationships are in relationships paying for things they've done bad in the past. Think about why your grandma hates your granddaddy, but they still together. Think about it. My grandma, this is a true story. My granddad died in 2019. My grandma hit him in the face. Get up. That's true. I hate to say it, but it's true. My grandma hates my grandfather to this day. I'm gonna tell you which one it is, because I got two or maybe one step grandmother or woman I call grandma, so you don't know who she is. But they cannot stand my grandma, my granddad, to this day, because of something that he did years ago. And people believe that because you're in a relationship with somebody for years, that you don't hate that person. It's many people right now in relationships and they hate their mate. They're only with them because of the kids. And in my case, my grandma and grandparents were just married together because, hey, my granddaddy had nowhere to go and she didn't have nowhere to go. And they were in a church community. But when you see them out, they can pretend that they like each other. They did not like each other. And Dwayne Wade, I honestly feel Gabrielle Union has never forgiven Dwayne Wade for having that baby on her. Okay? So all this time, he's been pleading to get her love back from when it first happened. And she just happened to still be there. And this is just something he's trying to do to make up for that. And I'm gonna tell you guys something. I'm real, right? I've made mistakes with people in relationships, nice women. I'm not perfect. I know you guys may think that I'm perfect, and I think I'm perfect too, but I'm not, okay? And I find myself trying to make light of, you know, something bad that I've did or I've said, you know, because sometimes, let me just tell you this, you know, a young men, when you're dealing with women, right? Here's how it works, guys. Women can say anything to you and hurt your feelings, but you will typically forget about it. And when women hurt your feelings, they don't care. All right? They don't. Women can be petty. They can say whatever the hell that they want to say about you, and they don't care about your feelings. And they expect you to get over it. But if you say something to a woman that hurts her feelings, she'll never forget about it. Never. It doesn't matter what, if you try to logically explain, well, baby, I know you're still mad about that from years ago, but this is what you did to me. She's not going to care. And guys try to, you know, try to balance that. When women are petty and you being petty, your pettiness is always going to hurt more to her. Because typically as a man, she's going to say, I'm sorry. She'll have, you know, she'll end up giving you some, you know, some sex or whatever. And eventually you can forget about it. Women don't forget about that kind of stuff. So when you say mean things to women, you got to understand it hurts more than when she says it to you, at least in her mind. Okay? Women don't forget stuff that you say to them, but they do forget stuff they do to you all the time. Women can do tremendous things to you and they forget about it and expect you to forget about it, but they never expect you to forget the things that you did to them wrong. Never. So when you say that out of anger or whatever, she gonna remember. And then that be held over your head for years, no matter what you do for that woman. You can pay the bills, you can go trips, you can do whatever, and if you cheated on her, she gonna always bring up that lady usually. And you never gonna get out of that dump. I'm telling you, as a man, I've realized in my 40s, you never get out of that. So here's what you gotta do to avoid going to the fact that I gotta get a tattoo on her. If this is the truth, you need to leave her. If you've hurt that woman so bad that she can't get over it, and you have to do things like get tattoos of her, try to make up for it, or do these things, try to make up for it. If it's that bad and you always saying sorry, number one, she ain't gonna respect it. Number two, and here's something a lot of you guys don't understand. The next guy that she's gonna be dealing with is not gonna give her nothing in comparison to what you're getting. And he's gonna get a whole better experience than you. Wanna know why? Because he's new. He's new. Many of you guys are still in relationships with women trying to get back to how things were 7 years ago. It's never going back that way. It's only going to go back that way if you get rid of her and she takes the time to go out there and date on her own so she can realize that you're good or not. And then maybe then you can do it. But even though you made a mistake, she got to fear losing you. Once a woman got that kind of idea that, you know, oh, well, you know what? He's always going to be here. She's never going to respect you. Look, baby, I made this mistake. Yada, yada, yada. I know it hurt your feelings, but this is not getting better. You need to get the fuck out. Or I need to get out. I can't overcome it. I'm sorry about it, but you got to go. Some women would withhold sex from their partners for years. You get sex relationships. Get her out of there. Let her go. Because the next guy she's going to go to is not going to do what you do. And that dude is going to be the one getting all the sexual experiences that you over here fighting to get back from 7 years ago. Let her go. Let her go. You start over newer with somebody else. Typically, the person looks better. You enjoy yourself more. You remember not to make the same mistakes. Don't tell women mean things you're going to regret. I had to learn it the hard way. If she gets on your nerves, just hang up or don't say nothing to her. Let her be petty by herself. These are things that I have learned over time. The best response for women is no response in the heat of the anger. Just don't say nothing. It's best. Especially if you love them. Just leave them alone. They'll come back when things is right, all right? And then once you understand that, move on. But having to get tattoos and all this stuff because you didn't had a baby on her before and all, she's going to punish you forever. I'm not saying this is the exact case with him, but I believe that this is what he's doing. But guys, what do you think? It's your boy, O'Shea Duke Jackson, back at it again with another episode of The Celebrity Drunk. Appreciate you for all that you do. Subscribe, hit the bell. We're out.